We have an update right now to a Target 8 investigation into who posted more than $100,000 to bail Grand Rapids riot suspects out of jail.
Target 8 investigator Susan Samples broke this story last week and has some new information for us tonight. Susan.
Brian and Sue, we have a new dollar figure. The Michigan Solidarity Bail Fund says it now spent $200,000 to bail out a handful of those arrested in the Grand Rapids riots, including one woman who allegedly streamed part of the riot live on Facebook. Target 8 confirmed Allie Lyons is the fifth suspected rioter to be bailed out of jail by a donor-funded pot of money. The Lansing-based Michigan Solidarity Bail Fund posted $40,000 cash to spring the 22-year-old Grand Rapids woman from jail pending trial. Lyons, accused of live-streaming the riots and charged with encouraging them, had already been bailed out once by a bondsman, but when her co-signer backed out, the bond was revoked and she was rearrested. The bail company told Target 8 the co-signer did not want to be on the hook if Lyons didn't show for court. No such concern, apparently, from the Michigan Solidarity Bail Fund, which said on social media it's now posted $200,000 to bail out 11 protesters. No one connected to the bail fund would talk to Target 8, but online the fund says it supports the justice movement and ultimately wants to abolish cash bail altogether.
I'm glad that this conversation's happening.
State Representative David LeGrand has been fighting to reform the cash bail system for years, says whether someone stays in jail pending trial should be based on their risk to society, not how much money they have.
Anything that violates principles of equal justice is a bad idea, and cash bond fundamentally does that.
It's an issue that's gaining more attention as community bail funds across the country see a big uptick in donations amid Black Lives Matter protests nationwide.
Whether you agree with the political agenda of the people who are doing this or not, the fact of the matter is cash bond is a broken system that is not compatible with the aims of justice.
LeGrand is trying to get a package of bills through the state legislature to make sure pretrial incarceration is based on risk, not a defendant's income level. We did try to find Allie Lyons today to get comment, but she has moved from the address the court had for her. Records show she and seven other riot suspects are due back in court tomorrow for hearings. We'll let you know what happens. Back to you guys.